Hey guys, this week's episode is how to ask sales questions. Hey guys, this week we're talking about asking questions. It's another skill set along with all of our series so far that is a key tool to be effective in sales. Josh, I think you have a quote for us to start off.
I do. This quote is by Stephen Covey and it says, "Most people don't listen with the intent to understand. They listen with the intent to reply." And I think that really sets the tone for this video because when we talk about asking questions, we're really what we're talking about is understanding. Asking a question, listening with the intent to understand what the prospect or customer is saying so that we can be better at positioning our product or service in a way that they want to accept, they want to buy from us. We're a solutions provider and not a salesperson at that point. So
you're not just giving them information that's bouncing back or bouncing off of them.
That's not the point of what we're trying to do. Yeah, we're trying to get to know them so that we can be more personable with our pitches.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So to dive into, I wrote down a note of what I feel like asking questions, what I benefit from it. And it's this is a skill most people in sales would say they know well.
Right.
But in reality, asking the right questions at the right time to uncover their needs is a skill set that takes time.
Absolutely.
Most people in sales, they're young. I've been in sales for about 6 years now, and you always have a lot of different ammunition that you have when you go and talk to somebody. You know what I mean? You're excited about this. I have this I want to tell you about. I have this. And really just going in and talking to a client or a prospect and just finding out what they actually need is bar none. Barely anybody out there and does it these days well.
Right. I agree. I mean, I think people get overreactive. They get so caught up in the classic sales training that they're not loose. They're not listening. They're not being a human being. I mean, people want to do business with people. We talk about that all the time. And if you're consistent about being a human being and understanding, and that's what people crave, is just to be understood. So if you understand what a office clerk is doing, what a executive is doing, and you go, wow, well, this is how I can make your life easier or better or make you more profitable, people get excited about that.
There's a lot of salespeople out there. There's many more people like you that are trying to sell to your same client or your same prospect. So you have to differentiate yourself by trying to find their needs. What's going to be important to them?
Right.
What's going to actually make a difference in their daily lives?
Right.
So a great example of that is if you're just prospecting or if you're going to be cold calling, go and see somebody, rather than just going in and just throwing questions at them saying, oh, you know, how much do you guys pay for this? Or how much do you pay for this? And you know, oh, you guys are working with them. Oh, they're a horrible company. You're just talking. You're just throwing darts at a board and you don't even know where it is. You know, go in. Ask questions like, you know, like first walk in and say, hey, you know, who are you guys dealing with? And usually this company. So now you know who you're competing against, which is a great piece of intel, and usually nobody has a problem with that. Then go in and say, you know what do you guys do for your delivery? Do they come in and just leave it in the front lobby, or do they actually take it to the back? Oh, they just leave it in the front lobby.
Yeah.
Small question, small pain point, but that person that you're talking to deals with that on a daily basis.
Absolutely.
And if you can save them 10 minutes compared to the last guy, do you think they're going to be interested in talking to you?
I know. I mean, you're giving a hint about next week's episode, but you know, one of the things too is even if you're selling intangibles like me, I mean, I sell websites, I sell web apps. I mean, it's like selling air at sometimes, you know. So I really have to listen to what's important. Oh, you're interested in making sure that people who visit your site from a mobile device can see your information. Okay, now I can position. If I ask the right questions, like, hey, have you ever looked at your website on your phone? No, you haven't. Do you think that looks good? No, you don't. Oh man, I mean, they're opening up the gateway for me to come in and offer an incredible solution for them.
You're having them answer their own questions.
That's the biggest thing, man.
You know, they're
selling themselves almost.
Oh my gosh, that's a great point. You just brought it up and you actually can solve that problem.
Right.
Huge. And a couple questions we actually wrote down just for examples.
Give them some examples, man. These are great questions.
A couple examples that we threw down. What do you want to see from, you know, if you're talking to a client prospect, usually it's in a meeting sense, as what do you want to see from your vendors? Just you're asking the prospect or client that. What do you want to see from your vendors? What is it? What would you like to achieve with this meeting? So we're meeting right now and we're talking and just say, like, literally, what are we both doing here? Why are we both sitting in this room?
Right.
So it's open-ended question. You're asking them what their goal is. Are there any others involved in making these decisions? So, you know, am I talking to somebody that we have to go through 5 different people to get this approved, or are you the main person?
You know, that right there is worth money. I mean, people forget to ask that question. They'll waste half a day selling someone that ultimately doesn't help you make a sale.
And literally you're wasting your time by telling them all this stuff when really they can't even pull the trigger.
Right.
So why give them all this information, give them your perfect pitch, and then be like, oh, wait, you need to call Joe? Oh, that's awesome. You
know? Exactly, exactly. So, well, let's wrap this one up for him, James. Sum it up for him.
So asking questions, really, as simple as that. Think about listening, 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 shut up and listen some more. Mm-hmm. Counter your sales pitch or the way that you're gonna, your objective with that customer mm-hmm. from a question and mm-hmm. finding the value or their need that they have. So find the value that they're looking for, fill that need by asking questions. So
absolutely.
Hope you guys like this episode. Please watch next week. Have a great week.
See you next week.
Okay. You look so dumb. Hey, everyone. This week is all about working remotely. Oh, shit. You guys, like, you're like stunting your ability to do this.